What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. We're gonna continue on with our Halloween horror figure reviews. I was out and I finally found the, I guess you'd call this the retro release of Trick or Treat Sam. If you've never seen this movie, it's a anthology horror movie. It's from 2007. It's like four different stories. And in the movie, Brian Cox is in the movie, Anna Paquin is in the movie. It's like four different stories. Every time someone breaks a holiday tradition, Sam, this character, pops up and ends up going to work on him. It's really cool. It's created a pretty big following, a lot of big fan base for it now. But I always loved the character. I always thought it was cool. He's like a demon. Wears a burlap sack on his head, wears orange pajamas, kills people with his lollipop. It's a pretty cool movie. I definitely recommend checking it out if you haven't seen it. And it's an awesome character. But so we're going to crack into this thing and open it up. I was happy to finally find this one. They have a ultimate version too, but I love the soft goods. I think it makes it look so much better. But so let's flip you guys around and we'll tear into this one. I'm excited about this one, so let's get to it. Like always, before we take the figure out, let's take a look at the packaging. Like all the NECA retro releases, I guess you would say, they come in this clamshell packaging. Excuse the glare, it's kind of hard to deal with, but I like these packaging. They're nice because you can actually cut along this real nicely and still keep this all for if you want it. You don't have to, or you get rid of it, whatever you prefer. But real straightforward. You got the figure in there, shows the figure, awesome. Then you get a nice, some nice artwork on the side. Really cool, really creepy. Loving it. Flip it over. You got some product shots. You can get some ideas. There he is without the mask on, really cool. There's that lollipop I was talking about, and he's got his coffee bean bag, his burlap sack he carries around. Have to watch the movie, find out what's in there. But then you got a little bio thing they give you. The doorbell rings, the cry goes out, trick or treat, but wait. What's actually going on during this ghostly All Hallows Eve? Something eerie and unexpected. Something splattered and spooky. Something that brings ghouls, vampires, werewolves in the night. Answer the door. A shocking surprise awaits. So that's pretty much it for the packaging. There's a barcode. Maybe it could be useful for you guys. I was seeing these randomly. It is one that they restock. But I just haven't been able to find them for a while since I wanted them. I've only been seeing the ultimate version. Well, I found this. I had to grab them right away because I've been wanting them. And perfect timing. Get them right before Halloween. Add them to our Halloween horror figure review. So, pretty cool. There's everybody that worked on the project. And that's packaging. Pretty straightforward. Oh, you got the choking hazard. Can't forget ages 17 up, so don't let your kiddies have this one. Anyways, let's crack this thing open. I'm excited for this. First off, straight out of the package, I'm really impressed with this guy. You got to be kind of careful with him because he's on like a little kid body. He's got some pretty thin joints and stuff, but we'll get to articulation. But like just looking at him straight off, The detail that went into this guy is just phenomenal. And he's been out for a while too, so, but I mean, just looking at the soft goods and everything, all the stitching, man, he just looks so good. But before we get too in-depth with him, let's go over the accessories. He doesn't come with much. He comes with his burlap bag that he carries around in the movie. Look at all that. It's all... It's got patches on it and everything. It looks like it's all beat up. They did a really good job on this. I'm really impressed. I mean, NECA usually goes all out for these figures, but I mean, that's just awesome that you actually get a real burlap bag. And then, of course, can't have Sam without his killer lollipop. And that's all he comes with. But what else does Sam need besides his bag and his lollipop? I mean, you look at the detail that went into the lollipop. Looks phenomenal. The striping, everything, just so good. Did such a good job. Now, for the grand finale here, take a look at Sam. I'm pretty sure that this part comes off so you can look at his actual head, so I haven't decided. We'll take it off for the review, but just look at the detail. All the stitching, just awesome. Got the patches on his pajamas. Look at his hands. Look at that. Just phenomenal work. This looks great. Got his slippers. His jail slippers. Prison slippers. He's even got the flap. This even has, it's got Velcro on it so you can take it off. Just so good. Now we can take a look at the articulation. Nice ratcheting articulation. So you get nice T-pose, straight across. I think everything is single jointed. It's hard. Yeah, he's got single jointed elbows. He's pretty small though. He doesn't need much. You got ball joint, leg, hips. Nothing at the waist. Oh wait, you can rotate his waist. So that's actually more than I thought. And then you got the single jointed knees. And then all you get for wrists and ankles is just a hinge. There's no rotation on it. You can rotate the wrists though. But yeah, the ankles, just a hinge, which kind of a little limiting, but you really don't need much for them. If you want, we'll try to get this, I'll take this head part off and, let me take this off once and see if I can get it off. All right, see you. Untie that. I feel like I'm gonna regret taking this off. And then there's, look at that head, man. Jaw even opens a little bit. But I mean, just look at the detail on that. Kind of got like a little pumpkin look to him. They did a phenomenal job on this. I'm really happy I went with this version. I'm sure the ultimate version is great. I really think the soft goods just nails this. And the fact that you can take the burlap sack off his head is just amazing. So I'm really happy I went with this version. So cool. All right, got that back on. It wasn't too bad. It was actually like a, I should have showed you, but there's a foam hood. Put that on first, and you just pull the burlap over it, and then put the sucker in his hand. I think it slides right in there. There's like a perfect little hole. Yep, there you go. You can kind of see the hole in there. There he is.
sucker in hand. I don't know if it goes any further though. It kind of stops. Yeah, I think that's it. Do some size comparisons with them real quick. Oh, I had them stand. There we go. All right. Let's see here. Put them up with Ash. He's a little, he looks a little taller than he does in the movie, but that's all right. I like him when he's a little, you know, he doesn't have to be perfect. Throw him up there with one of the predators. So he's a decent size, not too small, not too big. If you want, you can do an actual, get an actual size here. He's about 5.5 inches, I think. Yeah, I'd say 5.5 inches. Yeah, so that's a pretty straightforward review on this guy. Excellent. Highly recommend them. If you're a fan of the franchise, you will not be dissatisfied with this. If you run into them, I would definitely pick them up. I haven't been seeing them as much anymore. And I'll take one last look at them. One thing I really like about this figure is the hood option where you can actually take the burlap bag off. I think that is so awesome. Instead of having like swap out heads, I just think it's so cool. If I were to, if there was anything I'd want to change on this guy, is I'd want to give him some ball joints on his ankles just to get that ankle rotation. But other than that, there's not much I would need changed on him. I think he's an overall really good representation of Sam. I think it's awesome. I love it. Happy you can add this one to my collection. And hope you guys enjoyed the review. This is going to be it. I'm going to wrap it. So until next time, see you guys later.